Hey guys, this is Ricardo back again on the Watch With Us channel for another review. This week we have the Tutima M2 Coastline Chronograph, model number 6430-06. Now if you guys remember, we've had a Tutima back on the channel, I'd say a few weeks, almost months ago, and it was a pilot chronograph from the brand. This time around, we have a chronograph that's more geared toward your Navy men. In terms of, this watch has no issues at all getting wet. With that being said, let's jump into the specs on this one. Now for those specs. The M2 Coastline chronograph, which was released earlier this year by the brand, comes in at 43 millimeters from left to right. You have a 44 millimeter lug to lug. Thickness comes in at 15.8 millimeters. Going to the strap here on the front side, strap looks like it's going from 24 millimeters here at the case, tapering down to 19 millimeters here at the clasp. However, when you actually open the watch up, your lug width here at the back is actually 20 millimeters. Now, while we're at the back of the case, you'll see the case back with that polished ring, which contains information on the watch. You'll also see that the strap is actually rubber backed with a leather front. Going back here to the front of the watch, we have a beautiful blue dial, which has your date here at 3 o'clock, 30 minute counter at 12, 12 hour counter at 6, and your running seconds at 9 o'clock. Loom is applied on the indices here on the main dial. You have a dial which is actually mostly matte with the sub dials in a glossy finish. You'll also see a glossy finish on the chapter ring as well. Go here to the side, you'll see that your crown is signed with Tutima's T. Your pushers are actually PVD coated, which is a nice, comfortable feeling when you go to push your pushers, which I'm going to do right now. The watch comes with 200 meters water resistance, which is aided by, of course, a screw down crown. Inside, you have ticking Tutima's 310 movement, which is an ETA-based 7750 movement. They decided to go the route of the 7750 simply, one, it kind of keeps costs down and it makes the watch a little bit more accessible to more individuals. Taking a closer look at that dial. Loom, of course, I said, is on the indices as well as the hour and minute hand. No loom on the seconds hand. Now that covers it for the specs of the watch. Actually, one more thing I want to add. In terms of weight, this is a titanium case, so the weight of this watch actually only comes in at 114.3 grams. Now that we've got the specs out of the way, let's jump into my thoughts and pricing on the Tutima M2 Coastline chronograph. Now, I've had the M2 Coastline chronograph for about a week now, and I have to say I really like what Tutima did here. They took a very popular three-hand model that they had in terms of the M2 Coastline, turned it into a chronograph. You have that beautiful titanium case, which keeps the weight down. And that's probably the biggest thing I liked about this watch. It's a watch that at first, when you look at the specs, you think will be too big. But by keeping your lug-to-lug short and having only a 43-millimeter case, plus you add to the fact that it's a titanium case, the watch actually wears pretty well. I'm going to go ahead and just toss it on my 7.5-inch wrist so you guys see what I'm talking about. And there it is on my 7.5-inch wrist. As you can see, the watch actually wears pretty well. That short lug-to-lug helps a ton with this watch. I love the fact that the watch is pretty under the radar. It's a nice chronograph that I could see myself wearing from sunup to sunset, and it's just a nice purpose-built watch. Now, I know some people will look at this and they'll be reminded of maybe a Sin 144 ST, but what I like more about this watch is, whereas the Sin 144 ST, it pops, there's a lot of color, there's a lot going on there on the dial. This is nice. It's simplified. It's a definitely a popular color right now in terms of the blue coloring, but it just flies under the radar, and I really like that about this watch. As I said, I wore this probably I'd say about 5 or 6 times in the week that I had it, and not once did I feel that. Shoot, there were times I forgot that I had the watch on, which is just a great feeling. But then when you look at the watch and you see that beautiful quality that went into the watch, and it's one of those watches, you know, people always talk about the weight of a watch is kind of how they judge the quality of a watch. But once again, when you get into titanium, you can no longer just rely on that weight. You start looking closer at the watch, and you start to see just the beautiful work that they did, the slight differences in terms of brushing, the way that the case catches the light, the way that the pushers have this nice PVD coating. It's not a thick layer of rubber. It's perfect in terms of just resetting. There's a nice little grip there. The 200 meters of water resistance. You never have to think about, oh, you know what? I have to take this off if I'm jumping into the pool, which of course they thought about as well, because you get the rubber backed strap with the leather front. I mean, this is, I think, a home run for the brand. It's a beautiful addition to the M2 Coastline family. The only negative I have on this watch is I wish they sent it to me with the titanium strap as well, because I really wanted to get the whole feel of that titanium strap, titanium case, just that overall feel of the watch. Now, in terms of pricing, this comes in at $3,300. That's for the model that has this strap. If you want to go with the titanium bracelet, that comes in at $3,600. So that's, I think, is a reasonable price for a fully titanium watch, which has great quality from a brand that we all know that focuses on chronographs. I mean, Tutima is the chronograph brand. So you know you're getting a good quality watch from them, especially when you're buying and purchasing one of their chronographs. Now, that completes it for my review of the M2 Coastline chronograph. Have any thoughts? Have any comments? Definitely leave them in the comment section below. I'm pointing down when I should be pointing this way. If you happen to own an M2 Coastline chronograph, let us know what you think. Do you believe you made a great purchase? Are there any regrets that you have now that you're an owner? Definitely let us know. But that completes it for our review. And to send you guys off, I gotta run that beautiful chronograph footage.